Hey nerds, welcome to Jerry Bear Reacts. Today we're reacting to Euphoria, Rue Bennett, I Hate Myself. Posted by Infinity Edits, 116 subscribers, back on November 28th, 2019, with 13,500 views, just a little over a year old. Runtime, 513. If you want to watch that uninterrupted, a link in the description box down below. And if you're new here, feel free to subscribe for daily content. If there's a day, there will be reactions. Euphoria. Have I watched it? You guys should know this by now. No, I haven't, actually. I watched like 3 episodes last year. Sorry, nose was itching. 3 episodes last year. We're not going down that. I was with somebody. We were watching that show. It was good stuff. I enjoyed it. They really enjoyed this show. They love this show. So it was cool to get to experience something they really liked as well. So yeah, without further ado, without getting into that, Jerry does his best work behind the scenes, and we're gonna watch some Euphoria. This is good, because this is the first time watching this, like, and knowing nothing about the show. First time watching a tribute. Isn't Rue, isn't that, that's Zendaya, right?
A memory?
Anything that had an impact on you this summer.
I can't think of. I'm having trouble, remembering something, you know.
Just tell us a specific memory.
Bro, school's messed up for even doing that to her in that.
I was with my mom and my little sister, and we were listening to this song.
Hey, I'm Rue. I'm an addict.
I was once happy, content.
I'm very happy for you, Rue.
New chapter.
She won an award for this show, right?
Huh. And Gia.
I don't have all the pieces.
Absolutely.
I love Zendaya. She's an amazing actor.
To have her find you unconscious.
And I know it all may seem sad, but guess what? I didn't build this system. Nor did I fuck it up.
Yeah.
I don't remember much between the ages of 8 and 12. Just that the world moved fast and my brain moved slow.
Was she coughing to cover up the
every
sound
now
of the
and
mirror?
I focus too closely on the way I breathe. I die. Until every second of every day you find yourself trying to outrun your anxiety. And quite frankly, I'm just fucking exhausted. I know a lot of you probably hate me right now, and I get it. If I could be a different person, I promise you, I would. I'm not kidding you. Not because I want it.
I'm not trying to become best friends with someone who's gonna fucking kill himself.
But because they do. And there lies the catch. The hardest part has been feeling like I owe it to myself.
I don't know what type of fucked up shit you got going inside your head. I don't know how to help, but I can tell you one thing. This drug shit is not the answer.
Facts.
All of a sudden, I couldn't breathe. There was no more air left.
Wow.
That's the episode I watched, was this one right there. This is one of the episodes I remember watching, was that her getting pulled in the pool.
I don't want you to fucking check me, whether I'm fine or I'm not fine. What difference are you going to make?
This is the feeling I've been searching for my entire life, for as long as I can remember, because suddenly,
the world went quiet,
and I felt safe in my own head.
But when she wakes up, she'll be given the opportunity to get clean, to become a different person, a better person. Here's the toughest part. No matter what you say or do,
she straight swindled that jello.
The decision would be all hers.
and all you can do is hope. She gives herself the chance she deserves. Keep speaking to me, but I can't
have it. The other thing about depression is it kind of collapses time. Suddenly, you find your whole days blending together to create one endless and suffocating loop. So you find yourself trying to remember the things that made you happy. But slowly, your brain begins to erase every memory that ever brought you joy. And eventually, all you can think about is how life has always been this way. And it will only continue to be this way.
I'm a burden, and it is what it is, and it's embarrassing and it's stupid, but it's true, so I'm sorry.
The absolute worst part of depression is that even though you know you're depressed, you're unable to stop yourself from getting worse.
Let's talk about it. A lot of bars. A lot of bars in that. Man, it's weird. The collapse of time thing was the big thing I wanted to talk about because it's real. Like, I remember, like, 2008, right, lost my dad, and that stuff's kind of a blur, and I kind of found some outlets early on that was beneficial. But most recently, last year, 2019, from the months of September until I want to say like February or March of this year, is I got nothing. There's just nothing up there about it. Like, it's weird. I've mentioned it before. Like, I'm a very lucid dreamer, and I have this very vivid memory about things. Like, I can remember people in kindergarten and elementary school. I remember their first and last names, where they sat, our seating chart, basically. I remember people from high school, their first and last names, and, like, just different little things about them. Or if I watch something, like a TV show, or if I play a game, I remember all these, like, minor details. But September to about like February or March, there's nothing. And it went by so slow, but yet at the same time so fast. It's one of those things where, like, I would get myself together, I'd go to work. 20 minutes into work, I'd lose it. I'd have to go to a different floor or sit in my car and recompose, and I would do that on like an hourly basis. And the catalyst for this at the same time is like in the building, and it's like, man, you know, like every time I look up, there they are, boom, back to sitting in the car. That's really all I remember, are like those pieces. And oddly enough, starting streaming, I don't really remember anything from when I started like streaming, because I didn't have a consistent schedule. I just was streaming and playing a game. I remember playing the Star Wars game a little bit. I remember bits and pieces. I remember the big reaction thing that I had. That's it. Like Thanksgiving, I got nothing. Christmas, remember tidbits of Christmas. And then all of a sudden in like February, March, things got a little bit better. But that was like after months of like therapy and things. So the whole depression thing of like collapsing time is 100% true. Luckily, therapy was a very good outlet during that time period. And obviously in this character's case, they, with severe anxiety, which anxiety and depression, they go hand in hand. And when they combine, it is a struggle for any person, no matter how strong that you think that you are. They turn to substance, basically, to drugs, which you hate to see in a character or in a human, in a real world situation. I feel like probably every single one of us knows somebody who has been through some sort of addiction or something along those lines. It's a heavy show. It's a heavy show by just watching this tribute and the two or three episodes I watched. Again, the one of her in the suit getting pulled into the pool, which is a weird sentence to say. I remember watching that, and that whole monologue dialogue she just gave. I remember sitting on the couch listening to that while the person I was with was watching it. I remember that. That's about it from the show. This may be something I have to give a watch to. Again, I love Zendaya. She's an amazing actor. She seems like a great person. And I love her as Mary Jane, too, in Spider-Man. I think it's a great casting choice. She's, she won it. I can't remember what the award was, but I remember she won an award for this. I'm pretty sure I saw on Twitter. It's a heavy topic. And there are outlets. People do care about you. It sucks that therapy is expensive, but luckily some jobs have outlets for it. Some insurances cover it. There are outlets out there. So without rambling and getting too deep dive of that conversation, because this could go from 12-minute runtime where it's at now to 25 to half an hour to an hour if we really dove into it. But I love your face. And I hope you're drinking some water. Hope you're eating some food, taking care of yourself. I'm going to put playlists up on screen. We're going to have a second video for today that'll come on after this. And hey, recommendations and stuff as always, guys. Stay cute, stay hydrated. I'll catch you on the next one.